Hi guys, sorry. Hi guys, Zulkarnain here, and welcome back to Makoto Mobius. Last time we snooped around in a time loop area, well, in Makoto's house, and leave it. Let's just say Makoto's house and leave it at that. And left. We got bed and six. Let's try again. Go outside. Yeah, this time I'm going to try and go outside without doing anything at all. Let's see what happens. Makoto, you're still awake? Oh, so you were waiting for me. I just finished work. Sorry for being so late. Thank you, Makoto. It's been rough on me lately. Things haven't been going well at work. They got mad at me during editing. Oh, sorry, I shouldn't be complaining so much. That's why mom got fed up after all. You're on my side, right, Makoto? You wouldn't leave me and go off somewhere like mom did, right? I'm on your side. I won't go anywhere. I'll stay with you, Makoto. Hey Makoto, if I told you I wanted to die, would you die with me? Huh? See, it's gotten pretty hard to keep on living. I feel like I want to just end it all. But I'm worried about leaving you alone in a world like this. Wataru. So Makoto, please die with me. Are you Wataru or are you the dead? Ouch. I think you're Wataru. Huh. Don't worry, Makoto. I'm next. Now I can't. Makoto, I can't. I just can't do it. What an idiot. I know, I think this deserves an end. It pisses me off to no end this time. Because, I'm going to be honest here. I know life can get really hard from time to time, but just ending it all isn't the way to go. No matter where you are, how you got there and what other options you have, there's always somewhere you can go on in life. It doesn't necessarily have to be good or bad, but there's never any dead ends in life. So not only is killing yourself, in my opinion, stupid, don't do that. And secondly, killing someone first and then realizing you can't do it, come on, that's... I mean, is anyone really this stupid as this guy over here? Congratulations! You have achieved the newest level of stupid. I'm too scared to kill myself. There's no way I can do it. Arg! Makoto! Yeah, you should have thought that sooner. Makoto had died. She had been forced into a double suicide by her own father. Just what had her life been like for her to have died like that? Would I be better off dead? Why did she ask me that? I wasn't a friend or a family member. I was just her classmate. Or she never really spoke to at that. Yet she asked me. Makoto is the kind of girl who wouldn't ask for help even if she really wanted it. Makoto might have wanted me to help her. Exactly because I was neither friend nor family. Exactly because I was just a classmate. Perhaps that fact is the reason she was able to say those words at all. In case any of you are wondering why I don't voice act through these visual novels or any gameplay for that matter, is because by not doing it, I'm saving both your ears and my self-esteem a lot of pain. Wataru, I don't die. I wonder why. Why did I say what I did to someone like you? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that choice was pretty useless. Maybe I wanted you to help me. I couldn't tell anyone else, and I didn't want people to know. So I just chose you, the guy who sat next to me. I didn't even believe you'd come. Whatever this guy is saying, I'm having a really hard time believing she really thought it through. I mean, her plan to just tell something like that to the guy right next to her, it's got wrong and stupid written all over it. I didn't even believe you'd come. Oh yeah, I read that part. Hey, it's strange, isn't it? I don't have a future beyond this point. It's just been looping countless times. I can never escape from this. I don't even know what to do anymore. I'm just stuck in fate's loop. By the time I realize it, it's morning again. Wataru, I have to go. I would say, since you automatically somehow keep memories of your last life intact and it's an infinite loop, I'd recommend doing something akin to what Rika did. But you're probably not smart enough to do that, are you? Let's see each other again today. Thank you. Goodbye. Bye. Bad and one. I was watching. Yeah, you were. I like that music this time. Trying again. Okay, I know that doing that does this. Oh yeah, I check these things out. Okay, as far as I can tell... Oh, hello. We can actually go here. Some cold coffee is here. Inside the trash can, there's a folded piece of paper. Read it? Yes. I'm going to be late tonight. Go ahead and go to bed before me. From Dad. It's a calendar. The date hasn't changed yet. Oh. It's a refrigerator. Inside are a bunch of containers stuffed with side dishes. A faucet is here. A water filter is attached. It must produce some tasty water. Can you even have tasty water? There's a kitchen knife here. Take it. Nah. It's a stove. Turn on the gas. What does it even do? Actually, never mind. It seems that... Whatever is if I choose no. Oh, that. There's some curry in the pot. I wonder if Makoto made it. It smells kinda good. Can I eat it? Sorry. There's a picture frame here. In the picture are Makoto and what seem to be her mother and father. Everyone is smiling happily. A well-maintained... Okay. The dinnerware here all looks like it came from a dollar store. What a shitty TV! I probably shouldn't turn on the TV. You know what? As far as I know, our objective, since Miss Makoto here is not smart enough to take things matters into our own hands, our objective is to be Keiji. I don't know why I forgot his name for a while. Our objective is to be Keiji Maibara and influence this time loop in true Higurashi fashion. Inside the Sleeping pills. Force them down Makoto Dad's throat. Yeah, let's do that this time. If Fate said Makoto would die, if Fate said she would be killed by her father, then I'll just keep him asleep tonight. That way, no one will die. A June 23rd where no one dies. This is the answer I came up with. Wow. When I thought he said force them down Makoto Death's throat, I thought we were trying to kill him. But this is a far better solution. I don't know why I didn't think of that. I went back to my house. My house was alight, flames burning brightly. That day my mother died. Bed and floor, someone somewhere. Problem identified. See, sorry if I keep comparing this thing to something as great as Higurashi, the anime by the way, not the game, I haven't played the games. But in Higurashi, at least there was always a rhyme and reason for everything happening and why it happens and how it happens. Though it's not clear, you know, not inherently clear. By the way, we have some time, so I'm gonna try again. Like I said, so it's, since it's not inherently clear, it gets cleared up eventually, either in Kai or later down the road. But here, it happened just because. And yeah, you could argue about that excuse thing, but I think it's a contrived plot device, a convenient plot device actually. Is Makoto's dead? He's taking a nap. Kill him? Yeah, let's go with my original idea. Boy, I didn't see that coming. 24th, okay? June 24th. Makoto hadn't died. She had been saved. I killed her father and saved her. But Makoto cried her eyes out every day after that. But after a while, she slowly began returning to normal. Yeah. Good for her. Is this a new Makoto or a younger Makoto? How long has it been? I made everyone worry about... Oh, this is a new Makoto. She looks happy. That includes you. Sorry about that. But thanks. Now that was a real surprise. Mikio is always so bubbly, but that day she cried so hard her eyes turned red. It kinda made me feel glad that I didn't die. What? Huh? You know, I've been thinking about it this whole time. That's how it is, huh? It was you, right? You're the person who killed my father. You came to my house that day, didn't you? Why did you do that? Yeah, no way this Makoto is gonna believe that. But either way, I'm screwed, so that. So you're saying that I was supposed to die that day, but my father did instead. I won't accept that. He didn't even do anything wrong. Now this is actually a moral quandary I wasn't expecting from a game like this. If someone is destined to do something terrible, but hasn't done anything up until that point, is it okay to kill him? I never expected a moral quandary to come out of this one. How did you think this would all end up? He kept working for my sake. It was hard on him, but he kept doing his best. How? Just how do you think I felt living this way, living the way I for all this time? I was all my father had, and likewise my father was all I had. We were both saving each other. You don't get it. There's no way you could understand anything. You didn't save me by doing this. Oh, by the way, I am going to predict the future of this plot. Our boy Wataru is gonna die now. Even if you save my life, you can save my heart. If my father died in my place that day, if only one person was supposed to die on that day, then that day the one who died was my father. And today the one who dies will be me. Wait, God. Actually, I'm sorry about the quiet. I'm actually kind of surprised. Charon's games usually end with things going south. Really, 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 really south for our protagonist really fast. So I'm actually kind of surprised he's still alive right now. If this world was really such a painful, hellish place to live in for them, maybe this was for the best. Yeah, I guess so. And yeah, you, Makoto, you're an idiot too. Well guys, that's it for this episode of Makoto Mobius. If you like this video, please be sure to leave a like, comment and or subscribe. Dislike it if you hated it. I'm Zulkares and I'll see you next time.